And developing tonight, Westminster State Representative Faith Winter has come forward. She is accusing fellow state rep Steve Lebsock of making unwanted sexual advances towards her. Thank you for joining us for Denver 7 at 6. I'm Ann Trujillo.
And I'm Shannon Ogden. Chief investigative reporter Tony Kovaleski has been digging into this all day. You spoke to State Rep Winter today.
Yeah, Shannon, Ann. She's now telling us she's coming forward because she wants the behavior to stop. In talking to several respected sources at the state capitol today, they told us Representative Lebsock, who's also a candidate for state treasurer, has a reputation for crossing the line with females at the Capitol. One of his colleagues now saying, enough is enough.
My phone has over 30 text messages from lawmakers, lobbyists, aides, volunteers, thanking me for my courage in doing this.
This is something State Representative Faith Winter never thought she would do.
If I'm courageous enough, hopefully it shows other women they can be courageous enough.
Representative Faith Winter says when it happened back in 2016, she gave her colleague, Representative Steve Lebsock, a warning and a chance to change.
And I told Representative Lebsock that if I hear of another woman that he has sexually harassed, I would be the first to come public.
Now that you've gone public, relief?
Relief because I've spent the last 18 months trying to avoid Representative Lebsock.
Her colleagues have celebrated what they call a courageous decision to tell all of Colorado, and a difficult decision to share with her family.
Tell me about the discussion inside your home.
And I've been on the phone all day, and my little boy said, what's going on? And he's 8. And he said, what's happening today? And I said, Mom's saying, telling a brave story so other people don't get hurt.
In the middle of calls for his resignation, Representative Lebsock denied the accusations in an interview with our partners at the Denver Post. He said he was drinking the night of the reported incident and does not recall grabbing Representative Winter and does not recall making lewd comments.
There have been calls for Representative Lebsock to step down. Do you support those calls?
It wasn't the reason I came forward. The reason I came forward was for the behavior to end, but I do think that's an appropriate course of action.
Now, responding to the allegations, House Speaker Crisanta Duran issued a statement earlier today saying, in part, I would expect that Representative Lebsock would consider the impact and do the right thing and resign. Now, the House Speaker is far from being alone on this. Calls for Lebsock's resignation span both sides of the aisles and include at least 2 candidates for governor. Shannon, Ann?
Tony Kovaleski.
Thank you, Tony.
And Governor John Hickenlooper just responded to these allegations on Twitter, calling harassment unacceptable. He says women should have the ability to conduct their jobs in politics without fear of harassment or retribution.
And today I sat down with Colorado State Capitol reporter Marianne Goodland. She's covered the Capitol for 20 years and says the allegations don't surprise her.
The legislature is a horrible place for women. And it hasn't changed despite the fact that we have more women lawmakers among the Democrats now in both the House and Senate. We still have a huge problem with sexual harassment, and this has been going on for years.
And you can hear my full interview with Goodland on Politics Unplugged this Sunday at 4 right here on Denver 7.